And this is Candy once more from Candy's Natural Hair Namics, and this is my follow-up video from this morning. Those of you who may have seen it, I had shown you how to achieve a more moisturizing shampoo or more conditioning shampoo by adding aloe vera. And I gave you a heads up that I was about to come with a very, 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 very special homemade conditioning hair treatment, and I'm about to do it right now. I just washed my hair, it's all dried out, but let me get this done. Alright, so what I'm about to do today is called my YoBanaYa hair treatment, and by the sound of the name you may be able to get an idea, you know, what it involves, but if not, here goes. Let me show you the contents or the ingredients involved in this treatment. First of all, the yo is from yogurt. I am gonna use half cup of yogurt in this treatment or in this conditioner, whichever you want to call it. And the ban. YoBan is banana. I'm going to use a whole banana. Very moisturizing for your hair, can I tell you? It is super, super moisturizing. And it is so big on sheen also. So, you know, those two are two of my faves. And the aya, papaya. This is about maybe a quarter. Maybe I won't use all of it. You can use a quarter of a papaya. Depending on the size, you know, you have to use your judgment. But that's, yeah, like a quarter of a papaya. And of course, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of honey. My natural humectant. Awesome for sheen and moisture also. And for people with my hair type, you know, like a 4B, 4C hair type, you know, wherever you can get it from, you always seek it, seek moisture and seek sheen, because it always seems very lacking. Alright, so also adding two tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. An excellent source of sheen also. And that should be all that I can remember right now. When I'm done, I'll add my essential oils. But this is it. It looks so edible right now. Like a nice truffle or something. But let me just go ahead and blend it up. Are you serious? 1 minute, guys. Was unplugged, but it's not unplugged, so why not? There you go. Shake it up so it gets all incorporated and all the what you call it, all of the yogurt gets, you know, incorporated into the mix. Awesome, this should do the trick. Let me check if it has the desired consistency. If only you could smell this right now. Like, seriously, guys, I'm not exaggerating. This smells like a smoothie. Very thick. Not as thick as, you know, like the avocado. Of course, it wouldn't be, because the papaya in itself is kind of water-based, so it's not going to be as thick. dish or my jar. It's a nice orangey color. I always love when I get some very nice and appealing colors from my conditioners. You know, my favorite is the bright green from the avocado, but hey, this is also very pretty, like a peachy orangey kind of color. And I'm going to add some peppermint as usual. Those of y'all who know me knows I live by peppermint for my hair. 3, 4, 5 drops of peppermint. And then I'm going to add some lavender. Essential oil of lavender. Just for fragrance. And it's also good for hair growth. Alright. So there you have it. 1, 2, 3. And the mix is all ready for application. Right, perfect. Let me just add a little more of the yogurt, because it seems like a little bit watery. So I'm gonna add some yogurt just to thicken it up a bit. Okay, so there you have it. The mix is all ready, and now I'm gonna just quickly apply, and I'm gonna give you the feedback as to how it feels on my stresses. And I always make fun and call my hair my stresses instead of my tresses, but yeah, I'm gonna see how it feels on my tresses right now on my hair. Of course, I washed my hair out like a, you know, a while back, and so it lost all of the little moisture that was in it. All of the water has dried out, so that's why I have to re-wet it. Let me get my towel, YoBanaYa. Yeah. So I'm gonna just use my hands to just take up the mixture, the concoction, in my fingertips. And then I'm going to pull it right through my hair. And this is a messy one, guys. Because, as I said, it's not as thick as the avocado. The avocado is, like, super thick. So, it's not, you know, it doesn't have any runniness at all. But this one is kind of, you know, thinner than that one. So, it's kind of harder to prevent the what you would call spillage. Okay. And papaya, I don't know if you all know or realize, but quite a number of hair products on the market today are packed with papaya. They have papaya as one of their ingredients. And, you know, this is so because papaya is awesome for, you know, it's packed with vitamins, packed with enzymes, with minerals, you know. All the goodness that your hair could ever desire can be found in papaya. And so that is why I chose, you know, to use the raw papaya in my hair. So I can get the direct, unprocessed benefits from the fruit itself. Okay. Alright, so it feels awesome already. Feels very awesome, and it automatically stretches out the hair. And the hair just feels nice and bouncy, very soft, very moisturized right now. I can tell you it does. Okay, so let me continue. And the yogurt. Yogurt is a source of protein. And protein is always good for your hair. You can never have too much protein. Well, you can have too much protein. I take that back. But, you know, if you want to prevent breakage, or if you're experiencing any kind of breakage or any kind of shedding or any kind of split ends, whatever, you know, malfunction your hair is presenting, usually a protein treatment would be great you know, to have that corrected. So there you have it for the protein. And the yogurt is an excellent source of protein. Or egg is also a good source of protein that can be used in the hair. I'm sure I just saw that thing fly in my lap a while ago. Feels super soft, guys. I wish you could feel it right now. Feels so soft. And once you put it through your entire hair, especially concentrating on the ends, once you apply it to the whole head, then you're just going to go ahead and, as usual, you're going to cover under a plastic cap for maybe 30 minutes. If you can afford more time, then fine. You can't, you know, because you're working with natural foods, it, you know, there's no harm in keeping it in your hair for longer than 30 minutes, you know. Right, and this YoBanaYa treatment is feeling very awesome right now. Pulling it through, as you can see, very creamy. Feeling very moisturizing. And I'm almost there, guys. I don't want to keep you long today. I'm not in for a long video today. I just never wanted to lose the opportunity to share this one. I try to share something new every time. Every time I you know, discover something new, or I experiment with something new, or somebody shares something new, you know, I like to pass on the good news, you know. Just the same as you would pass on the good news about Jesus. Pass on the good news concerning a new revelation or a new discovery for your natural hair care. I myself have learned quite a bit from the girls on YouTube also, you know. Whatever they know, they try to share, and I also try to do the same when I find something new. Alright, so this is the last section right here. That was super quick. That was fast. Let me just wet the entire area in the middle so I can do the final application. Get it all saturated. Guys, like I was mentioning, you all need to go and look at my channel for my last video, how to add moisture to your shampoo, or how to achieve moisturizing shampoo. This morning I did that. I added the aloe vera, and you need to go and see that video so you'll be able to try it for yourselves and see if it works for you also. Like I always tell people, you know, when I do something, or when I show you something that I do in my hair, it won't necessarily work for everybody. Everybody has different hair types, and my regimen won't necessarily work for you. Yours won't necessarily work for me. And it's all about trial and error. Natural hair, all about trial and error, all about experimenting, you know, all about, you know, testing to see what works and what doesn't work. Whatever works, by all means, go ahead and stick to it. Whatever doesn't work, then you just, you know, forget about it and try to find something else that works for you. Alright, and all these recipes you can find on the website, on my website. It's naturalhairnamics.com. naturalhairnamix.com. And you'll find this and many, many, many more recipes. So that's it. I'm done. In record time, I'm done. And it feels super soft. Intruder. There's an intruder passing. My husband. He's hailing y'all up, guys. So, this is the end result. I can tell you, I love how it feels. And if you can, please get your peppermint. It just adds a oomph to all of my mixes, you know. Makes it just feel like so tingly and as if the penetration has been turned up a notch when I use the peppermint.
Medicinal.
So, yeah, my husband said it has medicinal properties, and I agree. It feels as if it has medicinal properties in it. Oh my god. So, there you have it. My YoBanaYa hair treatment. I'm all done, and I'm going to cover my hair with, unfortunately today, a shopping bag, because I did not get a chance to go to the store to get my plastic cap. So, based on my culture, I am taught to make do. So, right now, I'm making do. Alright, so I got my plastic cap going on, and I'm done. And that's all I gotta say to you today. You gotta try this one, guys. It's awesome. It's off the chain, off the hook, off the chisel. Okay? So, once again, this is Candy from Candy's Natural Hair Namics, sharing another one of my life-changing, hair-changing discoveries with you. And as usual, like I do all the time, taking it to you naturally. Peace. Check it.